Die is kidney. Nee.
Hoe zit dat? Kijk, hij doet dat.
Sorry.
Welcome to our latest Facebook Live event. I am Christina from Web Communications Unit, and I'm very pleased to introduce you the members of the Zahafi family, Mr. Ahmed Zahafi and Ms. Zoli Kafouzi. They are the parents of Nasser Zahafi, who is a finalist of this year's Sakharov Prize of Freedom of Thoughts. Nasser is currently in jail in Morocco, so he cannot be here to witness the ceremony of the Sakharov Prize, which will happen tomorrow, but we are here to talk a little bit about his story. Tomorrow is the day when the Sakharov Prize will be given. This year's winner is Oleg Sentsov, a Ukrainian film director, also currently in jail. And our second finalist, you had an opportunity to meet them this morning. They are the NGO that are saving lives in the Mediterranean Sea of migrants. So if you want to know more, scroll up. So, of course, we are here to talk about Nasser. He is the leader of Hirak, a mass protest movement in the Rif region of Morocco. And he was basically protesting to fight corruption, oppression, and abuse of power. He was arrested in 2017, sentenced to 20 years in jail. So, I could ask you first, who is Nasser? What kind of person is he?
على المبادئ الروحية
Nasser is a simple person. He is the son of simple people in Morocco. Nasser is a man who had the courage to tell the truth. Nasser wanted to change the reality in the region. Nasser was brought up in a household whose basis and morals are sincerity, authenticity, and integrity.
Why did he start with this activism? How come that he decided not to be quiet and to raise his voice?
لكن لماذا اختار أن ينتفض وأن يخوض الجهاد؟ ولماذا لم يختار فقط الصمت أن يكون بسيطا ويبقى على بساطة؟
في الحقيقة هو بسيط، ولكن البساطة ليست في العقل وليست في القيم المبادئ، البساطة في يعني شخصيته وكانته وكاريزما خاصة. فالناصر الزفزافي منذ صغره ومنذ نشأته كان يكره الظلم ويحب الصدق، ودائما كان صادقا مع نفسه ومع عائلته ومع الآخرين. لهذا عندما جاءت قضية طحن محسن فكري في شاحنة للنفايات انتفض وكان صادقا في انتفاضته.
Well, as I said, Mohsen was a simple man, but simplicity does not mean being quiet. Simplicity also means that you have principles and morals that you have to defend. And since he was very young, he always felt that he had to fight injustice, and he did that with sincerity. Nasser rebelled when the fish seller, Mohsen Fikri, was trashed, and this did not, he did not like it, and that's why he rebelled and he started his revolt.
And a lot of people followed him into this. What do you think about this? What do you think about the importance of people's voice to be heard?
كان هناك كثير من الناس الذين تابعوا ناصر وكان ربما يسمع صوت الناس، فهل كانت هذه مهمة بالنسبة له؟ ينبغي أن يكون شخصية قوية، أليس كذلك؟ لكي يدعمه الكثير من الناس.
الحدث وشخصيته عفوا شخصيته هي التي جعلت له كاريزما خاصة به، ومع صدقه في الحديث ومع أخلاقه ومع ما دعا إليه نظرا للظروف التي عاشها الريف وعاشتها الخشيمة خاصة منذ 24 نوفمبر 1984 بعد إصدار ظهير عسكرة إقليم الحسيمة، ونحن نعيش نوع من التهميش. فمنذ ذلك التاريخ إلى يومنا هذا، فناصر من بين قاتلي الذين عانوا وجاءت فرصة طحن محسن فكري ليخلق حراك
الريف وحراك الشعب. ناصر had a charisma, so he could lead people, and because of his sincerity and his faithfulness. And do not forget that Husayma, Al-Husayma, the region where he comes from, is a very difficult area actually, which has seen a lot of marginalization since 24th November 1984, when there was a royal decree that actually was enacted to militarize the area, and the people in that region suffered a lot because of that. And Nasser was rebelling because of what happened to Mohsen Fikri.
How is he now? Is he feeling okay? He's been in jail for some time now, and how is he dealing with the situation?
نصر he's in good health.
At this time.
Yes, he's in good health at this time. At the beginning, yeah, he was tired, he was not feeling very well, but now he's great. He suffered about his feet and his hands. Especially when he was in a solitary confinement, he suffered a lot. He stayed 1 year and 3 months in solitary confinement. But he is a strong guy.
What are his prospects? I mean, we know that he's been sentenced for 20 years. Are there any chances for appeals in this process?
I know that the sentence is
20 years ago. There is a change in this time, and there is a change in this time. يمكن أن يزيد من مدة المحكومية، يمكن أن ينقل أن ينتقص منها، ولكن نحن نريد
البراءة من هذا
الإنسان وجميع الفاكهة، لم يرتكب شيئا ونلفه فارغا.
Yes, well, the decision makers in Morocco say that, that there might be an appeal now, but the result of the appeal can be an extension of his prison term or a reduction of prison term, so we don't know. But what we want, what we request, is that he should be declared innocent, and his colleagues also, because they haven't done anything wrong.
We have some reactions on Facebook while we are now going live. Daniela Rumpan, Anna Gasto, Maria, they say hello. Hello back, guys. Asmea Jansen says free Zafzafi, and they're saying free all innocent prisoners in Morocco. And Marilina from Instagram is asking, do you think your son will change something?
لن يستطيع أن يغير شيء لي لأنه ليس بيده شيء، فهو وفمه. أما بالنسبة لدول الدعم فالعالم بأسره مع ناصر الزفزافي باستثناء
well, our son by himself will not be able to change anything because he cannot change his well himself. But thanks to the solidarity movement that he is receiving from all over the world, I think there might be things that could be changed. But others, the other ones, do not support him. So it is a very good situation.
Well, I can tell you there are a lot of hearts and messages of support for him.
رسائل دعم كثيرة جاتي على فيسبوك الآن
فهذا دليل على ما أقول وتواجدنا هنا في مقر البرلمان الأوروبي له دلالات كثيرة معنى أن العالم مع ناصر الزفزافي ورفاقه في المعتقل وأرجو من المسؤولين في وطننا أن يتفهموا أو يقرأوا أو يحللوا تواجدنا اليوم في هذا المقام.
Actually, that is proof of the solidarity that Nasser really needs, and we thank everybody for that. The proof also is that our presence here can bring actually this solidarity, and I hope that the officials in Morocco can hear and understand and analyze this presence and this solidarity the right way.
And I should ask, what does Sakharov Prize also mean to you? I think you have answered this question, but if you could say a couple of more sentences.
I think in Antotina, Ibrahim, رأيت بشأن سأل أجبت عنها هذا السؤال هل يمكن أن تضيف شيئا؟
It's very important to be in the final as well.
ما دام الشيء بالشيء يذكر فجائزة سخروف قيلت في المحكمة في الدار البيضاء أن ناصر الزفزافي مرشح لجائزة سخروف ولكن قيل أن الجائزة هي انفصالية معنى ما معنى جائزة انفصالية فأندري زخروف أنا كنت ليس مع صدق حتى أقول أعرفه ولكن كنت أسمع عليه أنه كان وزير الدفاع في الاتحاد السوفيتي سابقا ولكن أعتقد أنه تذكر شيئا ما فأصبح في موقعه يعني لا نقول انشقاق له حرية الفكر اسم على مسمى بالنسبة لجائزة سخروف لأن جائزة سخروف عندما وصل ناصر الزفزافي إلى الثلاث الأواخر فهذا يعتبر للريف ولناصر ولجميع المعتقلين نصرا في حد ذاته.
Well, it was actually the Sakharov Prize was mentioned during the court proceedings. There were court proceedings at that time, and the Sakharov Prize was. But it was actually considered a separatist movement. You know, it was considered to be given by people who supported separatism in Morocco. So that was a little bit tainted with that. And Andrei Sakharov, I don't pride myself in saying that I know him personally, but I knew about him. And I knew that at one point in time, I think he was a defense minister or something. And and then in the USSR. But he is actually known for the freedom of thought, and
yes.
He is mostly known actually for that. And but Nasser being among the last three candidates for Sakharov is for his colleagues and for himself and for the reef is a great victory.
Thank you very much for that. I just need to say that we had a lot of messages of support, people saying that are praying for your son.
Thank you very much.
Thank you
also.
How do I say thank you?
Shukran.
And everybody, please, I need to just say, stay with us tomorrow as well, because we're going to have a very long Sakharov-filled day. We are going to have representatives of Oleg Sentsov, who is this year's winner of the Sakharov Prize, and he will be live. They will be live at 4 o'clock as well. The ceremony of the Sakharov Prize will be live. We will be broadcasting that from 12 o'clock. And of course, in the morning, stay with us if you want to know more about the future of Europe. This time we have the President of Cyprus in the European Parliament speaking about his vision. So thank you very much, and thank you.
How it was the views and did
it was good.
Good.
And we
unfortunately for us, it's like in the next 24 hours, it wasn't even we're going to promote a little bit more to people interested in human rights as well. And you can share the video afterwards if you want. We can share it through Mina, through you, so you can have some more material.
Yes,
and thank you for having me.
ثم دوني ننتقل للقاء الصحفي اللي كمر خويني توغيكي كيسن لايف البرلمان الاوروبي المهم جاوبن خلا اسئله اللي سن النان جنميكين روح خذوني انت بعد ما رانو فاش من غنصوات نصوع عاود نتقاذك اني مره مسامحه